So here I am attempting to fix my New Holland 273 baler. You can see that the knotter assembly right in here, the knotter frame is damaged. It is causing, basically caused other problems when that broke. I have a broken knife arm, which I've removed. But now what I'm attempting to do is take off the entire knotter assembly. I've removed the bolts here on the side, as you can see. So what I'm trying to do now is remove the entire knotter assembly off of the baler and start replacing some parts. All right, so again, I'm trying to remove the entire assembly here for the knotter. All right, so we've got this arm here. I guess you call it the needle arm for the needle swing. Was attached by this here. That was on the edge of that right there. It was hooked into there. I've already taken that out. Okay. So what I'm going to do now is remove this shield here so I can have a little more access to that. I'm working on taking that shield off. I've already removed these bolts down here on this side. One here and one there. All right, on this side of the assembly. So I've removed those bolts over here, these bolts over here, and the trip arm I've already taken out of place here. Just swing that up, take it over, get that out of the way. I might detach it or I may leave it on there. I'm not sure yet. If it gets in the way, I'll end up removing it. But for now, I am gonna remove this shield and see if we can't get this assembly all the way off. So what I've had to do was disconnect the yoke arm here from the knotter shaft. All right, this entire shaft here. Had to disconnect this here by loosening the nut and bolt here. All right, so I've got the knotter assembly pretty much free to come off. Just gotta maneuver it out of here. Slide that all the way through. And we'll take a look here. Okay, so I think this knotter assembly is ready to be separated completely here. Put some gloves on just so I don't pinch a finger or something. And I'm going to pull this thing off. See, this arm fell back down into place, which is why I might need to remove it. Okay, there we go. And let's move it. Alright. Moving. Here, I need to get this on. Out of place here. But I think we are mostly there. So I will just maneuver my way out of that and then send you pictures of it fully removed. Okay. The knotter assembly is successfully removed. Alright, you see the yoke arm is still there. Been detached. Let's swing around here. I'm going to take this opportunity to really get in there and clean this out. Change those hay dog springs. Those are just bad. I got a couple new ones there. I'll change those while I got it, while I'm at it. Alright, and then start disassembling this knotter assembly here. I'm going to order some new parts here. So as I start taking this thing apart, I will video that as well. Okay, so here we are back. Got two brand new knotters. Alright, they're going to replace... I'm going to go ahead and just replace both these knotters, even though the one is the most damaged, but quite frankly, neither one of them is in really good shape. I believe the cleanouts aren't working properly. They're just old. So I'm going to take those apart. I'm going to save the pieces, but I'm going to go ahead and disassemble the entire knotter here. I believe what we got here is this cotter pin holding everything together, so I'm starting to remove that, and we will see how easy it is to start removing the pieces from there. All right, here I am on the other side of the disassembly and reassembly of the entire knotter assembly. I wish I would have been able to document the entire thing, but it's just, it's too messy of a job for me to be grabbing my phone every 2 seconds. But basically, all these individual parts here slide off the knotter shaft once you remove this lock here. That lock can be removed. It might take a little bit of effort, but it takes some channel locks and basically grab it. You know, grab on both ends and really work its way out. It will eventually come loose. It may be a little bit difficult. There are three of those, all right? That's the one that fits into the arm. Excuse me, not thinking straight. The needle arm. The arm for the needles. So that will, the shaft for the needles. Arm, needle, shaft, whatever it's called. So that fits into the baler. That's one there. This part has a lock under it, so this part does not freely rotate. And there's another one under this disc here. Okay, so there's three of them. They all need to come out. And then once you put it in, you need to make sure everything lined up. Now, if you have one of these nifty manuals here, which I do recommend you get, it tells you that all the right specs and spacing for everything. So, for example, you know, from here to here, for example, should be, it says B there, and you reference this guide up here, and it tells you exactly how far apart it should be. On the 273, should be 7.5 inches, okay? So that's very helpful. You'll be able to see then that it does line up correctly. So if we go to here, look at B, it goes from there to there. 7.5 inches. And if I have the knotters in the right place, you'll see that it comes down and it comes out to about right there. Okay, so I don't have everything lined up correctly right now to measure it, but it goes to the end of that, into the knotter there. It is lined up about correctly. Okay, so let's. All right, excuse me, I got cut off a minute ago, but basically I was telling you the specs on here are in this knotter booklet, if you have one. Otherwise, I will try to remember to post it on here so you can see the exact specs. Those are important. You know, the 7.5 inches from here to the end of the knotter, for example, that has to be exact. All right, if it's not exact, you will run into problems. So, like I said, this booklet tells you a lot of the different dimensions. You know, from here to here, for example, should be exactly according to the book, 18 and an eighth inch, and I checked it, and it does come out to 18 and 1/8 inch. So I'm going to clean this thing up, get some of this excess grease off, and we will reattach this to the baler. And hopefully we will have a baler that ties knots. I will get back to you. Well, here we are with the knotter put back in place. Pretty much the reverse process of taking it off, obviously. Tried to clean it up a little bit. Still a work in progress. Haven't had the chance to actually fully test everything, but here it is. Hopefully in functional condition. Checked all the specs. You know, the gap, the space, everything, you know, making sure everything was the correct distance from each other according to the manual, and it checks out. So theoretically, it should fire up. We shall see. I'm sure there's going to be some little adjustments going to need to be made. But here we are. Little work to be done. I will work on some more tomorrow. Getting this thing tested. I do go ahead and start greasing it up. That way it should be ready to go. Okay, we'll check it out later.